Welcome! In this video, you will learn how to create a simple multiband compressor with the included devices in Bitwig Studio. My name is Mattias and this is Morning Dew Media. Let's go! Before we start the multi-compression design, I think we need some audio to work with, so let's record a little acoustic guitar take with the Seagull acoustic guitar, and then we will create the multiband compressor. Okay, so what kind of devices do we need for a multiband compressor? Well, let's open up the device browser of Bitwig, and we only want to view the Bitwig devices. Then we go to audio effects, and then you can see we have the Multiband FX-2 and the Multiband FX-3. And what these devices do is that they split up the audio, the frequency spectrum of the audio, in three different areas. So you have the bass area, and you have the mid-range area, and you have the highs. And you can see that here in this device, the low, the mid, and the highs. In a regular compressor, you're compressing the overall frequency spectrum, but with this multiband compressor, you're compressing the different areas differently, if you want. And then with this multiband effect, we can go into each of these device slots within this device, and we can go and add the dynamics processor from Bitwig. You could use the compressor, but if you look at the attack time of the compressor, it only goes down to 0.2 and the release only goes down to 38 milliseconds. But generally with a multiband compressor, you want faster attacks and faster releases. So if we then take the dynamics, we can see that the dynamics goes down to with an attack of 0.1 milliseconds and the release to 10 milliseconds. So now we have this dynamics processor inserted in the bass area of our frequency spectrum. And then we can play with the ratio, maybe set it to 0.4. And just let's play back the audio and see what happens. We can set the attack slightly up to maybe, let's set it to something around 30 milliseconds, and the release around 10 milliseconds, 13. In the spectrum window, we can see how much compression we are doing to the signal, and currently you can see that the audio level is not reaching our threshold. So let's reduce that. We start to get some compression. Maybe a little bit more, a little bit lower threshold. And now, in order to control these separately, because if we look at the multiband effect, it has a mix level adjuster. But that will adjust the overall mix for all these three different slots. But with this type of multiband compression, I think it would be cool if we add separate mix controls for each of the bands. So let's add this chain device. So now we have a separate mix for this bass compressor. And now when this part is created, we can actually just select the chain device in this low slot and then hold in Alt and drag this to the mid slot and also drag it to the high slot. And now we have three different compressors for each of the bands in the frequency spectrum. And then let's go to the mid, open up the chain and look at if it's affecting the signal. Maybe drag down the threshold slightly. Decrease the ratio slightly also. decrease the attack to maybe go around 8 milliseconds, 6 to 8 milliseconds. These attack and release times, it really depends on the material that you have, but it's very good to experiment and see what kind of result you get. So there we have some compression going on. And go into our highs. And for the highs, we will decrease the attack and release even more. And you can see, since the acoustic guitar sound is more centered in the lower mids and the lows, we have a lot less compression going on the upper range. So we can decrease the threshold slightly for that one too. Yeah, so now we have our multiband compressor set up, but we want some controls, some easy access to controls to be able to control thresholds for the different areas of the spectrum field. So what we do, we go into the wrench icon within the multiband effect, and then we create the preset page within this remote controls editor. So just press the plus sign there and add this performance. Now we can press the learn button for any of these slots. Press the learn button and expand your lower view to begin with, and press the mix, this mix knob of the chain. Do the same thing for the next there, go to the mids and learn the mix knob for the mids. Excuse me. Then go to the third and do the same thing with the highs. Then below here we will do the same thing, the learn button, go to the lows and select the threshold. Do the same thing for the mids, select the threshold. And then for the highs, press the highs and learn the threshold. And then we have to rename these because they say mix, mix, mix. And it should actually read low mix, mid mix, and high mix. And same thing here, low threshold, this is the mid threshold, and this is the high threshold. So now we have three different mix level controls. And then of course we also have this, the mix for the whole compressor. And actually I will add an EQ before this multiband compressor, because this wasn't the most perfect room to record in, but we can get rid of some of the lows, some of the absolute lows, before we go with the audio into the multiband effect. Like that. So with this multiband compressor we can do some really creative stuff with our recording take. So let's boost the highs a little bit to get a little bit more crisp out of this guitar sound. Maybe reduce the lows slightly, increase the mids slightly. And then we can choose how much we want to blend this multiband compression into the original audio. Maybe have the lows really controlled with this multiband compressor, and the mids and up range a little bit more slightly processed. So you get a much more controlled sound with the multiband compressor. And then let's finish this sound up by adding some, a little bit of blur. We can actually use this blur doubler preset to get the guitar a little bit more stereo. And then add some reverb. Or yeah, let's use the Valhalla Rune reverb instead. Thank you. Yeah, so that's how simple it is to create a multiband compressor within Bitwig Studio. If you have any questions on music production, sound design, or using any of the devices in Bitwig Studio, please shoot me them in the comments below. Okay, so what do you think about this multiband compression setup in Bitwig Studio? I think it's a really solid setup and you get access to all these different controls of every compressor for each band of the spectrum field. It's not OTT by any means, but hey, OTT is free, so go and download it at Xfer if you prefer to use OTT. My future-based single, Gellhain Fly, is finally out on the streaming platforms like Spotify, iTunes and Amazon, so go and check that one out. Okay, so that's all for today and now you can continue and watch my next video. Thanks to all the new subscribers, we just hit the 2K mark. Really lovely, thank you so much for joining this musical journey. Thanks for today and see you in the next video. Bye!